on the outside looking in at the 2006 playoffs, but getting back into the postseason won't be their biggest hurdle in 07. Considering what's happened to the Broncos since the last game of the regular season ended, training camp and the games ahead will be as much a healing process as an attempt to regain their winning ways. Rachel Nichols has the story.
36-yarder from the left hash mark. There's the kick. It is long enough. It is good! San Francisco has taken the Denver Broncos out of the playoffs.
Moments after an overtime kick knocked the Broncos out of a playoff berth, players used words like agony, suffering, anguish. But hours later, those words took on a very different meaning.
The pain of missing out on the playoffs Sunday for the Denver Broncos quickly and shockingly was put into perspective.
Denver Broncos cornerback Darrent Williams.
24-year-old Darrent Williams
was shot and killed early New Year's morning.
Club the stretch Hummer Williams was in was fired upon.
It was absolutely horrible. You know, sports is sports. You know, it's our livelihood, so to speak, but it's not bigger than life.
It really didn't sit in until I got to the hospital, and it's like, God, we all in here. My trainer's here. One of my coaches is there. It was just an unbelievable moment.
I woke up, and it was on every single channel. It was heartbreaking, you know. Every time I think about it, it just makes my jaw drop. I just think that one minute you see somebody, the next minute you don't.
Cornerback Darrent Williams was dead, killed in a drive-by shooting in downtown Denver. He was 24 years old. 5 days later, the Broncos flew with a team to Texas to remember him.
Because you think in 2 years, all right, you're a young kid, you aren't going to have that much of an impact, but he did. He had a great impact on this whole organization.
He always picking my brain about something, and it hurts me that, you know, I lose him like that, because I didn't get the opportunity to push him over the hump and to see his career progress, and, you know, that really bothered me.
Then, less than 2 months later, with players scattered for the offseason, another round of phone calls.
One of my friends called me and told me, man, I just didn't move for the rest of the night. I was just so sad and just in shock. Just couldn't move. I was really just in my bed and didn't move the whole night.
Running back Damien Nash had collapsed and died just hours after hosting a charity basketball game. He was 22.
You can't really talk to your friends and family about it because they're not experiencing what you are, and they're not feeling the way you feel about that person.
It's almost like, who's next? Like, what's the worst? You know what I mean? It's almost bad thinking, you know what I mean? You just start thinking all these thoughts. It could happen to anybody. Is it going to happen to me?
Many players were still struggling this spring when the team reunited for the Broncos' off-season workouts. It was then that football, the thing that had seemed so trivial amid the deaths of their teammates, began allowing them to once again feel whole.
I was having a real hard time dealing with it, and I think getting back to here and working out together has been the best thing to deal with it. You're able to laugh and smile and be with people who you know are feeling the same way you are.
Under the circumstances, we've been a lot closer, I think. You know, I see my teammates a lot more outside of the locker room. We spend a lot of time together. We travel together here and there. You know, it's definitely a better cohesiveness than in the past.
I wasn't much of a text messenger, but now I get a lot of text messages and guys just saying, hey, calling to see how you're doing, and just making sure that everyone's doing okay. And I think there's a lot more communication between us.
Broncos have already put 27 and 29 decals on their helmets, marking Williams and Nash's numbers. And they wear t-shirts bearing the words, "Already," the catchphrase Williams used when breaking defensive huddles.
I put up some pictures, and the program from D. Will's funeral was in my locker, and just pictures and stuff like that. And you want to make sure you remember them. I think a lot of people on the team have wristbands and stuff like that with D. Will's name on it.
Yeah, there's been times where, you know, you're on that last sprint and you're not sure that, you know, you want to push, but then you say, hey, you know, I know a couple guys that would love to be here and don't have that opportunity. You know?
I do what I do for them. I don't do it for me. You know, I take the hits I take. I catch the pass I catch for them. And so I'm still out there with D, and I'm still out there with Damien, because, you know, they're a part of me.